Come on, give him glory. Come on, he's worthy. I said he's worthy of the glory. He's worthy of the glory. Hallelujah, he's worthy, he's worthy. He's worthy of the glory. Hallelujah, he's worthy. He is worthy of the glory. Amen. All the glory belongs to him. I said all the glory belongs to him. I said all the glory belongs to him. Amen. And nobody gets his glory. Nobody sees his glory. You can't even take credit for you being here right now. Nobody gets the glory. Not your alarm clock. Not your husband and wife who said, get up now. All the glory belongs to you. And we ought to be thankful that God woke us up this morning. Anybody grateful that God woke you up this morning? You should never take it for granted. But there are many people who laid down last night that didn't get up. As Minister Erica said, God touched us with the finger of love.
Yes.
And told us to wake up. He has need of us. So since he woke us up, and since you are in church, we came here on purpose to give him glory. Do I have a witness in
here? Thank you, Jesus.
Because there's somebody who didn't know that God has been good to you. That was three of us. Anybody else know that God has been good? My grandmother used to say, he's been better than me than I've been to myself. Do I got anybody else in here? Yeah, God is an awesome, he is an awesome God. I'm excited this morning about a lot of things that God is doing. What God is doing in the life of Brookville and in our lives, our family's lives, personally. I'm excited to have my wife with me sharing the pulpit today. Amen. Amen. This is her second time or first time. I don't know what time it is, but I'm glad you're here.
Thank you.
Amen. And thought I would need help today because I'm going to talk about something that's important to the body of Christ. And if there was ever a time for you not to go to sleep, it would be this month, amen. Because we're going to be dealing all month on this subject. And that's about tithes and offering. See, it got quiet right there. See, that's why I needed your help today, baby.
All right.
You got me?
I got you.
Okay, all right. Come on, we ask that you stand to your feet for the reading of the scripture. We're going to look at Luke chapter 6. Luke chapter 6, verse 38. I want you to get into the habit of bringing your weapon, your sword, your Bible with you to church. I know we have it on the screen and all that good stuff. But you need to get in the habit of having your word with you. Amen. The Bible says heaven and earth will pass away, but the Lord will stand forever. Luke chapter 6, that's New Testament. Right after Matthew, Mark, Luke. Amen. Luke chapter 6, verse 38. You'll find these words recorded in the King James Version of the Bible. It says, give And it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, and shaken together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom. For with the same measure that you meet withal, it shall be measured to you again. Again, it says, give, and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, and shaken together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom. For with the same measure that you meet withal, it shall be measured to you again. I'm going to talk about very simply tithing and offering a matter of obedience. Tithing and offering a matter of obedience. Would you help me and just look at somebody and just say, we're going to talk about giving today. We're going to talk about giving today. Tithing and offering a matter of convenience. Today I want to reconnect for some of us and connect with others about this issue of tithe and offering. And I need you to really pay attention today, because I believe that this is one of the most important subjects that God has given us to talk about in the Bible. This idea of giving. For those of you who already give tithes and your offering on a consistent basis, today I want to give you a different perspective on how you can make the giving experience in our church more rewarding for you. Now, there are some subjects that we talk about in church that we can preach and hoop about. Yeah. But then there are those subjects that you have to teach, amen. You have to teach. And this is one of them, because there are so many people that have so many different views about God's principles on giving. Now, make no mistake that giving is a principle. A principle is something that has rules and never changes. Are you with me?
Yes.
Giving, this principle, God's principle on giving, has become so subjective. Many people have different interpretations. So I believe that if I give it to you from the Word, just based on what the Word said, more simple, then I found that you don't have to argue with me about my opinion, but you have to argue with God. Are you listening? Now, I've never been a proponent of beating people up about giving. I've learned to just declare the Word and let the chips fall where they may. Are you with me tonight? Now, for those of you who are at a place where you don't tithe, or you give very sparingly, even the offering, I want to share with you, and I want to show you today how, by not tithing on a consistent basis and giving your offering, you literally tie God's hands, and He's not able to bless you like you should be blessed. Mm-hmm. Are you with me? Because one thing that God does not do, He will never violate His own principle. I just read to you from that scripture. It says, give. Right? It started off by saying what?
Yeah.
It says, you give and it shall be given. God cannot violate His principle. Say this, say, God will never violate His principle. Now let me share with you before you all hang up on me and go to sleep, because I want you to hear me. Everything about God's principles of giving has nothing to do with Him taking away from you, but it's all about what He can give to you.
Now, y'all, I should have had an amen right there. It's all about what he can give to you. He said, if you give, then it shall be given in what?
Good measure.
Pressed down, shaken together, and run it over. Shall men give into your bosom. Now, he didn't put that type of giving on us. He said, just give.
Yeah.
And again, all of this principle is not about what he can take from you, but it's about what he can release unto you. Are y'all with me?
Yes.
Now, I don't believe that God would be better to me in sin than he would be in salvation.
All right.
So he said, give, I want to release something unto you. Sister Howard.
Okay, now we as Christians, we always ask the question, what is a tithe? I'm going to tell you what is a tithe is. It is a tenth of your gross income that God has given for you to show your obedience to him by setting it aside and offering it as a worship and calling it holy unto him. The tithe deals with the commerce of the day. Back in the Old Testament, the commerce of the day was animals and land. So that's what they gave. But make no mistake, the commerce of today is money.
Absolutely. Look at somebody and say, it's money.
It's money.
We have cynical people in church. We have cynical people in church. And they would try to skate around this issue about, is it money that God is talking about? Look at somebody and say, yes, it's money.
Yes.
It's money. So let's talk about, I'm going to move quick because y'all going to sleep on me already. Turn the house down. Let's talk about this idea of holy unto the Lord. Your tithe is holy unto the Lord. Now, when we hear the term holy, we think about clean or white, pure. Amen. But when the Bible speaks of holy, it really means to consecrate, to set aside, to set apart. When you consecrate yourself, that means you are in a place by yourself. You're set apart from everything else. Are you with me? So when you're consecrating your tithe, it's you're setting it aside wholly to God. It's not just you giving money, but this is something holy that you are setting aside for God.
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes.
It's when you consecrate, it really means for an exclusive purpose. Are you with me here? Romans 12:1 says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercy of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, there, that consecration again, and acceptable unto him, which is your reasonable service. He said that you're setting your body aside, you're consecrating it, holy and acceptable unto God. Say this, say, my body.
Exclusively used by God.
Amen. That's where we get the word holy matrimony. That means that you have set yourself apart for your mate and God. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Now, God takes what is consecrated very seriously. Amen. He takes it very seriously because it's given to him.
Mm-hmm.
Are you with me? I'm talking a lot because I'm trying to keep y'all awake. Because see, this one of these subjects y'all go to sleep on. I ain't got no help in that. He takes it very seriously because you have thought enough to place this apart. You have consecrated it and you set it aside, holy and acceptable unto God. You have consecrated it to God. It's holy. Say, it's holy.
It's holy.
It's holy. Now, I don't care if you make $10 or I don't care if you make $10,000. I don't care if you are a public assistant or whatever it is. When God has given you something, God expects you to set something aside holy unto him.
Yes.
Are you with me today? He takes it so seriously.
Let me tell you how seriously God takes it.
Let me show you how seriously God takes it.
He takes it so seriously that when you don't do it, hear me, he calls you a robber. He said it in Malachi chapter 3, verse 8. He says this, and God gave me revelation in this way. He says this almost in a cynical sense. Like, will a man rob God? Will a man rob God? Yeah, then he answers it. Yet, you have robbed me. But I say, where have you robbed me? And he's making it clear, this is where you robbed me. You robbed him in tithes. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, don't be a robber.
Be a robber.
Yeah, you robbed him in tithes. You robbed him in tithes and in offering. Now, giving your tithe and offering has nothing to do with if you like the pastor.
That's right.
I don't hear no helping here. It has nothing to do with what the church doing with the money. I ain't got nobody in here. But it's all about an act of worship and obedience to God.
Yes.
Touch your neighbor, say, wake up. Don't go to sleep on this one. Don't go to sleep. It's about your act of worship. When you're tithing, it is worshiping God. You're bringing God something holy. And it is an act of worship.
Yeah.
Robbing God is serious. Look at somebody say, robbing God is serious. Come on, please tell them now. I think robbing God is serious. Let me show you something else that I found, Deacon Morris, and it blew my mind. How serious God takes when you rob him. When you rob God of tithe and offering, he wants you to give it back to him with interest.
That's right.
I know Mother Cobra tripped me out too.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. He wants it back with interest. Y'all ain't gonna help. I'm gonna show it to you. Go to Leviticus chapter 27. He wants it back with interest. Leviticus chapter 27, verse 30-33. Watch what it said. Leviticus chapter 27, verse 30-33. Hear what it said. And all the tithe of the land, whether of the seed of the land or the fruit of the tree, is Pastor Howard. Y'all ain't reading.
It's the Lord's.
It says, all of the land, all the seed of the land, or the fruit of the trees is the Lord's.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Y'all see it? It says, it's what?
Holy.
It's holy unto the Lord. Watch this. And this blew my mind right here, where it just dumped me right here. I was like, Jesus. And if a man will at all redeem aught of his tithe, in other words, if you will take the tithe that belongs to God, he shall add thereunto the 15th part thereof.
Yeah.
Y'all miss it. He asked for 10. He said, if you take it, you got to give 15 back. Please get your neighbor and say, please wake up on this. If you take it, you got to now give 15%. I know it got quiet right there. I know it. Verse 32. And concerning the tithe of the herd or of the flock, even of whatsoever passes under the rod, the tenth shall be the inheritance. Again, what? Holy unto the Lord. The tithe is holy unto the Lord. Say this. The tithe is holy unto the Lord. Verse 33. He shall not search whether it be good or bad, neither shall he change it. And if he change it at all, then both it and the change thereof shall be what? Shall be holy. It shall not be redeemed. Don't you ever think that God needs what you've given him?
Amen.
I ain't got no help in here. Is trying to show you the importance of what you offer him in worship and being obedient.
And don't you think that whatever Don't you think that you are even helping him out? Because whatever you have, he gave it to you. If I give you $20 and tell you $2 belong to me, don't act like you have given me something because you haven't. If I gave you the $20, obviously I didn't need it.
Ain't that a mess? God teaches us principles, brothers and sisters. How you can be disciplined and have a disciplined life through giving. He tries to teach us principles on how you can have a disciplined life through giving. You see a person who's a giver, you'll see their lifestyle matches their discipline in giving.
Yeah.
Isn't it amazing that those people who try to hold money back from God don't have nothing anyway? Ain't nobody gonna talk to me. The more you steal from God, the more you don't have.
That's right.
And what you hold from God, I told the story before, if we don't get it one way, so you ain't holding nothing, you're making life harder for you. Tell somebody, don't hold back on God.
Don't hold back on God.
Yeah. You know what's amazing to me, and I'm almost there. What's amazing to me is that we do all this bucking and joking. We shout and we lift our hands and we give God glory. But then when we come down from all of that, there's no faith to back it up.
That's right.
Yeah. And tithing is all about faith. Do I got some help in here? The Bible says that faith without works
is dead.
That's dead, boo. That's dead. That's dead. All of that shouting, all of that stuff we do, if you can't perform it, if you can't make it walk out after you finish praising and worship, after you finish all that stuff, if you can't show action after it, it's dead.
It's dead.
All right.
It's dead.
Yeah.
Say it's dead.
It's dead.
Look at your neighbor and say it's dead.
It's dead.
How can you shout and tell people how good God is to you? But when it comes time for you to show how good he is by giving him an act of worship and giving, then you close your purse up. I ain't got no help in here, but I'm a preacher like God told me to preach. God tests our faith. Come on, we test our faith.
The scripture says, consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know the testing of your faith produces perseverance, James 1, 2, and 3. God literally tries and tests our faith. He does it in many ways. One way that he does it is by this giving principle.
Yeah, he does it by this giving principle.
Yeah.
He tests your faith. He sees if you just a lot of talk. Ask your neighbor, say, are you just a lot of talk? He sees if you just go through the motions or if you really about what you say. Do you really believe God has been good to you? You know, do you really believe that he'll supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory?
Yeah.
Amen. So he literally tests the credibility.
Yes.
Watch this. He literally tests the credibility of your shout. He literally tests the credibility of your praise, of your dance, of your prayer, of your thank yous. He tests the credibility of what you sing about, what you worship about, what you preach about, by how you give. Ain't nobody gonna say nothing. Yeah, it tests your credibility, watch this, by your accountability in giving. He tests you.
Yes.
You know, a whole lot of people talk a good game.
Yeah.
We know how to look churchy. We know how to do all of that. Amen. But when it comes time for you to put up, they used to have an old saying, put up or
shut up.
I ain't got no weapon here. I ain't say that. Y'all say it. Y'all real quiet in here now. Look at your neighbor. Just say, boo. You know, just want to wake them up. I'm just trying to wake them up. We have heard so much deception about giving.
Yes.
That when you hear truth, it's foreign to us. don't even accept it. I mean, back in verse 32, he said, then concerning the tithe of the herd or the flock, even whatsoever, Leviticus chapter 27, 30 through 33, I mean 32, or whatsoever passes under the rod, the tenth shall be holy unto the Lord. Verse 33, he shall not search whether it's good or bad, neither shall he change it. And if he change it at all, then both of it, the change thereof shall be holy. It shall not be redeemed. Listen, God is simply saying to us, don't just give me anything. Don't just give me anything. Giving is your worship. Are y'all understanding this? Giving is literally your worship. The church thing got kind of empty too. It's literally your worship unto God. It's especially highlighted in the New Testament. God really tests the attitude in our heart and giving. Are you with me?
Yes.
Now, just like it's a specific way to worship, God asks for a specific in time. Are y'all with me here?
Yeah.
Stay with me now. This is gonna bless you. He asks for a specific. He asks for a tenth. A dime out of every dollar. That's it. A dime out of every dollar. How many dimes do we throw away? All the time. You can't buy nothing with a dime, all quiet. Can't buy nothing. Come on.
Okay, when you just start giving anything or nothing to God, it represents that you don't care anything or nothing.
You don't care anything or nothing. When you just bring him anything or nothing, it represents you don't care anything or nothing. The widow Mite, y'all remember that story in the Bible? The lady called the widow Mite. She impressed God. She shut God down. Because they were coming around for offering, and Jesus was watching, and this old lady, she gave her last. Mm-hmm. And people who had a whole lot of money was hardly given anything. And it blessed God. He said, she gave more than all of you all did. Mm-hmm. Even though y'all gave a bigger amount. But she gave more because of the percentage that she gave.
Yeah.
She gave her last. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me today. That's all right. She gave her last. She gave her last. God does not honor equal giving. He honors equal sacrifice. Your sacrifice at $10 can be just as great as somebody's sacrifice at $500. You may only make $100 a month or every 2 weeks. So $10 is a lot of money. I ain't got no weapon here. And see what happens, God gave me this. See what happens is that we come down to the altar. God bless me with this word. I thought about why do we have our trays at the altar? Why do we come around and we have our trays at the altar? And what God gave me was the reason we come to the altar, this Jesus gave me this, I don't know if it's right, I feel like it's right. The reason we come to the altar is because the tithe is something we're presenting to God as holy. Mm-hmm. I ain't got no help. And the altar is the place of sacrifice.
Yes, yes.
I ain't got nobody in here.
Yes.
It's a place of sacrifice. And what bothers God, when people come around, there are some people who come around and you give them $10 because that's a sacrifice. And then there are people who sashay down here and give $10 and it ain't a sacrifice.
Mm.
And the altar is the place of sacrifice.
Mm.
I ain't got nobody in here. It's blood that was laid on the altar. So when you come to the altar and give, you should give something that's painful to you.
That's right.
I know it. That's all right. It's a sacrifice. Look at somebody and say, it's a sacrifice. It represents pain. Blood was shed at the altar. The altar is the place of pain, sacrifice. That's why when we come and pray, you're bringing something to the altar. You're bringing your pain. You're bringing your cares. Here, you don't say it. You see, you come to the altar because it's a place of sacrifice. Come on.
Okay, God looks at what you have versus what you give to determine the credibility of your shout, your praise, your dance, your prayer, your thank yous, what you sing about, and how you usher, and how you preach.
So why should you brag about giving tithes? Should you brag? Why shouldn't you brag? Huh? You're supposed to do it. You ain't doing nothing but what you're supposed to do. You don't call Nipsco up and say, hey, I just made a payment. You don't call Squint and brag about it. Come on. You don't call your car payment. You don't call them folk and brag about it. I mean, if you did, they'd be like, that's what you're supposed to do. So you should, and I said this because you hear people, well, I pay my tithes, you're supposed to. Come on, anybody ever heard that? Well, I pay my tithes. That's what you're supposed to do. Look at somebody and say, that's what you're supposed to do.
That's what you're supposed to do.
Well, you don't brag to those other establishments because they would definitely look at you crazy. And see, when you pay your bills, it's a reflection of your credibility.
Mm-hmm.
See, God gave me this too, man. God gave me this. I saw the call you asked about this. Your credit score, watch this, is based on your promise to adhere to the contract for service or product offered to you. Your credit score. You adhere to the contract. Amen. Based on the service or the product that's offered to you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you have entered into this covenant contract with God at salvation. And God expects you to honor the contract. Look at your neighbor, because I got to wake some of y'all up. Man, y'all should see some of y'all. I'm telling you, I'm about ready to bring some pillows and covers in here for y'all. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor. God expects you to honor the contract. The covenant contract. God tests your credibility of what you say.
Yeah.
Amen. He tests the credibility of what you say. You'll say, God, if you bless me, I will. How many people ever said that beside me? Come on. Tell the truth, shame the devil. Huh? It's a contract. You say, God, if you bless me, I will. Now watch this. The differences in service rendered from the world system is that there are no guarantees. No, ain't no guarantee. Your contract will run out. Your payment will increase with no increase in service. In fact, it will go up higher and the service will go down lower.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Have y'all seen a Big Mac lately? They ain't big no more. Have you seen a Whopper lately?
Mm-hmm.
The devil is a liar. I went Mother Cobra to get a big fish from Burger King and it wasn't big no more. But the price go up. I ain't got no help in here. Yeah. But with God, tell somebody, say with God.
With God.
What he gives in quality, yes. And in service. And in support. I ain't got nobody in here. And in product. Come on, Marla, you want to make some money today. And in blessing God. I ain't got. And in protection. Him being good. Come on, get on the ground for me, brother. Come on, and in him holding you in his arms in the midnight hour. And in him keeping his arms around your family. And in him keeping your mind in perfect peace. You cannot compare. I dare you to give somebody a high five and say, ain't nobody like God.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody like God. No. He don't decrease in service. He increase in service. I ain't got no help in here. Anybody here know that our God increases? I mean, every round goes
higher.
Oh, my God. Hey, it seems like the more you give, the more he'll give to you. You ain't got any help in this house. The more God will give to you. Will you touch your neighbor and say, he'll give
somebody and say, he'll give you more.
Give you more.
Come on, come on. Just say, he'll give you more. If you don't know he'll give you more, don't say it. But there's a couple of us in here that know God will give you more.
Yeah.
When I feel a shout in this place. When you give it to God, he'll give you more. I ain't got no help in this house. How many times when you ain't got it? God will show up. I wish I had some help in here. Time when you're down to your last time. You think anybody in here know that God will show up just when you need him?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Somebody know what I'm talking about. You giving your last, but God showed up. You think anybody here know that he'll show up? I feel something working right through here today. I got some time and then you know what I'm talking about. You were faithful in giving to God. And then some stuff happened through the Lord. But God held it back. I ain't got no help in here. Have God ever held back a tithe from you? Is there anybody in here know that you are holding back? Hey. Christ. Oh God! Come on, trust three people and say, he'll hold it back, he'll hold it. Come on, come on. I need some real people in here who know. How do you shout on a time and message? Look at somebody and say, because God will hold it back.
Sweating today. Mother Cobra was just gonna chill today. I got my new suit on and everything.
But when I think of the goodness of Jesus,
oh God,
and all that he's done for me, I ain't got no help in here. When I couldn't do it for myself, I ain't got no help in here. Oh, my soul, I try to hold my peace. Sometimes I try to get you and be true, but when I think of the goodness,
oh God,
come on, I dare you to touch these people and say, he's been good to me. Say, I'm a tithe and he's been good to me, huh? God Almighty. Let's just see more people that say you've been good to me. Yeah. He'll hold it back. Oh my God. Somebody know what I'm talking about. You got one witness in here. You ever been in a place where you ain't have your money? But you didn't lose one piece of weight. You didn't lose one night of sleep. Because of God we serve. He keeps on. He makes it right. Oh God. Out of my way. Oh God. And because he keeps making ways, I will bless him. Somebody in here that know God is faithful. I said, said, I got some folk in here know God's faithful.
Yes.
I said, I got some folk in here know God's faithful.
Yes, he is.
Let me see if y'all gonna keep shouting after this. Y'all sit down. I got 2 more minutes. We got it. So, why do you say 10%? My brother, why did God say 10%? Why not 30% or 40%, 50%? He said 10%. I just want to dime out of Alabama. It's just may have the cheese, Mother Coleman. It's been 10%. It ain't like the banks. It's not based on the economy because God don't need what you got no way. It's worship. And it's obedient. Why 10%? I looked. I tried to find it. My team couldn't find it. So I prayed. I said, God, okay, you got to give it to me because I need to know why. Why 10? Why 10? Why not something else? And he gave me revelation. He said, I told the member that I can divide into evenly. To where when you give it, then I'm able to take out of it evenly and give it back that much. But watch this. He said, not only do I give back what you gave, I'm going to give you more. But I needed an even number to talk, mama. You got it, don't you? You've been looking at my notes. God's trying to look at your neighbor and say, God's trying to break you off something. Right. So, y'all ain't ready for this, but I'm going to give it to you. Tell your neighbor and say, buckle up, buckle up. There is even a realm, watch this, where you double your tithes. I told you, y'all ain't, I just lost half of the room right there. Yeah. This is realm where you even double your tithes. Yes. You say. I remember when we was young, Erica, and you know, we, before we fought, you know, we used to go around with the shoulder thing first. You know, we used to go around in the circle with the shoulder thing. You know, and you know, you bump shoulders and you know, you go around, and then after you finish going, I don't know what that was about, that going around and so. And then after you go around in a circle, and then you stand and you say, I dare you to hit me. I dare you. And then they don't hit you, then you say, I double dog dare you. See, when you say, I double dog dare you, that means you ain't playing. I got no help in here. That means that you're serious about what's about to go on. I ain't got nobody. So when you're able to double your giving, y'all got quiet. See, that was half of one. Now I'm about to lose the other half on this one. Watch it. Then there is a Peter walking realm of faith where you walk on the water on giving. Ain't nothing there, but you walk based on faith.
That's right.
There's a realm where you tithe based on what you want to make. I just lost everybody. Y'all gone now. You tithe based on what you want God to give you. Mother Covey, well. What you want to make. What you want God to give you. That's a crazy realm of faith. Well, Reverend, that sounds good, but see, I don't say nothing that I can't back up. I don't say anything that I can't. Matthew chapter 9, verse 29, look what it said. He said, then touch he their eyes, saying, according to your faith, be it unto you. You all know we always say that scripture, speak those things that are not as though they are. So you tithe based on you already got it.
That's right.
Oh God. Am I helping anybody in here tonight? You tithe based on you haven't seen the numbers yet, but according to your faith, the scripture.
scripture said, be it unto you. Faith is the substance of things, the evidence of things. So you tithe based on what you want God to do.
That's right.
Look at your neighbor and say, y'all ain't ready for me, y'all ain't ready. Mm-hmm. It says, according to your faith, according to your faith, be it unto you. This word according, God gave me this revelation, the word accordion, this instrument, accordion. Look at the picture. Don't let a man too old or rapping. It's an instrument that is stretched in order to produce the music. And it's the wind that is stretched out in order to produce the desired result. See, the problem that many of us have is that we never want to stretch ourselves in order to produce a desired result. Look at your neighbor and say, you got to stretch yourself.
You got to stretch yourself.
When much is given,
much is required.
You want much, but you give little. Tell somebody, you got to stretch yourself. This word according also means in proportion of how much faith you have. According to your faith, in proportion to your faith, be it unto you. God's going to do it based on the amount of faith that you got.
That's right.
I ain't got no weapon here. Come on, Sister Howard.
Okay, and the word worship is from a Latin
word. Listen to this. Come on.
The word worship comes from a Latin word, worship.
Worship. Come on.
How much is he worth to you? To me, he is priceless. That's why I can give him my all. That's why giving is about worship, because it shows his worship to you. How much is he worth?
Worship is worship. When you do it, it shows how much he's worth to you. Yeah. I wonder what your credit score with God is.
Ooh. Wow.
I wonder if you got a good credit score with God. Does it reflect your natural credit score? Tell somebody, please bow here, man. What's your credit score with God? How much is God worth to you? One woman in the Bible, she broke an alabaster jar on Jesus' feet. Washed his feet. Some theologians say that oil that was in that jar was equivalent to a whole year's wages. She broke it and used it on Jesus' feet. His feet. He like them feet y'all got now. You know, that one to go to the little Chinese woman shop. And she scrubbed all that rust off. I ain't got no weapon here. Do I got any biscuit face instead of me? I ain't the only one, don't play. If I told y'all to take your shoes off right now, y'all be like, nah, Reverend, I'm nah. We can see y'all feet right now. I'm almost tempted.
Don't do it.
She used something that was so valuable. On something back in those days, they didn't wear Gucci's like we wear now. They didn't have Michael Kors, no. They had sandals. And they walked around in a hot day. But he was the nastiest part of their body. Because it was uncovered. And she used the most expensive thing that she had as an act of worship. Oh God, what's this? Judas, the one who betrayed him, he got peed off.
Yes, he did.
Judas was the treasurer of the 12 disciples. I think Judas wasn't no joke now. No, Judas was an important man. He was the treasurer of the disciples. He got upset because
because this woman used this valuable oil on the feet of Jesus.
Thought the money probably could have been used for something better. And I'm about to let y'all know. The problem that we have, Dean, is that you got folk even in church that got a Judas spirit as it relates to giving. See, you come to church all the time, and we can preach about anything. We can preach about sundowning.
Oh, thank you, Jesus, thank you.
But when we preach about money, it's like we struck a nerve or something.
That's right.
I ain't got no help in here. Y'all get quiet. Y'all want to come to church. You preach. I'm preaching about this all month long. All month.
Yeah.
Y'all want to come to church. Oh, he going to preach about money. You know, we talk about it. They just, all they talk about is money over there. Because you haven't understood this principle of giving. You got a Jesus spirit. You feel like this money that I give, why give it to the church? It's too valuable to give to the church. You can buy some Michael Kors and get some Malaysian hair. Get some tips on. I ain't got no weapon here. I'm cracking mama up tonight. You have a Jesus spirit. Because you haven't got delivered. God, the Lord, talks more about money than he talk about anything else.
Yes.
And it's not to take from you, but it's to give to you. He wants to bless you. Look at your neighbor and say, he wants to bless you.
He wants to bless you.
Come on, tell him he wants to bless you.
Bless you.
Come on, tell him he wants to bless you.
Yes.
Bless you. How does he do it? When you give something at an act of worship, holy unto God, which is your reasonable service.
Yeah.
Have God been good to anybody in this building?
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
I want you to prepare to give. I want you to prepare to give right now. And I want you to ask God. I want you to ask God. So God, am I in error in my giving? Am I in error in my giving? You're about to come to the altar. You're about to come to the place where sacrifice is given.
Yes.
Sacrifice. 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 If you don't have it, you ain't got it. God understands that. I can't look in your place. God does. He knows.
Yes, he does.
And watch this. You gotta get to a place to where that phrase, I ain't got it, is not becoming me. Did you hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Not because of our frivolous spending. But you gotta be a good steward of what God gave you. Come on, Geeks, I'm gonna try to get the training. Because we're about to present this holy to the Lord. I want today to be a mind-changing message for you.
Thank you, God.
That my tithe, talking about tithe today. Next Sunday, I'm going to talk about offering. My tithe is holy to God.
Yes.
Are y'all with me?
Yeah.
It's holy.
Yes, it is.
If y'all mad at me, don't get mad. Get with God about it. It's holy to God.
Yeah.
And whatever you was going to give, ask God, is this what you have me to give?
come to the place of sacrifice. Coming to the place of sacrifice. You're giving it to God as holy. I know God, y'all got me? It's holy to God. It's holy.
Yes, sir.
Would you lift your hand and begin to worship a holy God? You're about to present something holy to Him.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Even holy God. Come on, open your mouth. Even holy God.
Thank you, Jesus.
He's a holy God.
Yes, He is. Hallelujah.
Come on, church. He's a holy God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
I'm about to worship Him with my giving. He's holy. Thank you, God. He's holy. I don't ever want to sing. I don't ever want to sing. Everyone sing. A swipe machine is working. If you need to use that. I want to thank Mother Colbert and Mother Halliburton's and Deacon Alford's and her brother who counted my arrival with me. When they can't be here, they make sure their ties is here.
Yes.
Because they understand it's holy to God. Would you lift your hand and give me worship one more time?
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on. You're about to worship God who's giving right here. You're about to present something holy unto God.
Thank you, God.
Come on, open your mouth and give Him glory.
Hallelujah.
I want you all to turn. I want you with the last eye to come down. When you give it in the bucket, you are making a deposit in worship to God. You're not just giving money, but this is worship.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The way that you will not tithe this month means to be your month. God wants to bless you beyond your wildest expectations. He wants to bless you.
Thank you.
Like only God can. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh. It's worship, it's worship. Hallelujah. It's worship. It's worship.
Thank God, thank you for the tithes and offerings. Thank you, Jesus, amen.
Come on, we're standing. We're standing. Don't forget, next Sunday, our OSHA celebration. Please plan on attending. Just for a few moments, all the single